Received. Right-handed print, missing the right index finger. This matches what we got from the crime scene. I processed all the prints. And Thomas, the print you got from the tape recorder at the metro station isn't on this hand.
I don't get it. What does that mean?
I'm not sure. I'm just saying that the print from the tape recorder wasn't made by the same hand. Size and dispersal pattern indicate victim sustained a heavy blow. Height of blood on wall indicates it's possibly a head wound.
Yeah.
Cross-referencing. The footprint is an exact match to the print I found in the metro station car. It may be the matchmaker, but I'm still concerned about that rogue fingerprint from the tape recorder. Keep following the trail. It may lead to answers. Maybe even a body.
I would if I could, but this part of the department store is flooded. His trail ends here.
It might be a long shot, but try using your gas spectrometer. Dead bodies start decaying immediately, producing hydrogen sulfide and traces of methane. If there's a body, you should be able to sniff it out. The air sample contains usual city pollutants and high concentrations of mold spores, and here we go, methane. It's relatively weak, but definitely there.
Yeah.
murder scene. But it's not quite right. Looks like you have a male corpse and a female mannequin. Exactly the opposite of normal. Well, not normal. Thomas, photograph the victim's face.
Guy's the matchmaker. Well, he certainly didn't kill himself and set it up this way.
See what else you can find.
What is it?
Too early to call. Small particles that show up as a potential organophosphate pesticide. I'll work more on that and see what we get.
Thomas, we know you're in here. Keep yourself out!
You can cross off the matchmaker. Wait, are you implying that there's someone stalking serial killers? So what, he goes around killing killers and then he marks off their name in his little personal diary?
Sounds ridiculous, doesn't it?
It does, but it adds up. It almost makes sense. Hold on. Ah, shit. Melissa, I have to call you back. Yeah.
You were going to call me back.
Sorry. So, the fingerprint in the metro station and the boot print are not the matchmakers, but this other guy. So, is he the torturer?
Doubtful. It's not the torturer's M.O. Think about it. The final murder in each of those cases on your list ended with a killing similar to the previous ones. This guy goes around and kills the killers in the same way that they're killing the innocent. He's like an Uber killer, a serial killer X, a perp not on your original case list.
So, this serial killer X kills serial killers. He takes them down using their own methods. If the torturer is still at large, what's his M.O.?
Pretty sick stuff. He likes to abduct people, torture them for fun, then let them loose and hunt them down. His goal is to drive them to suicide so he doesn't actually deliver the final blow.
What is this city coming to? All right, so I've got to find the torturer and save his ass so the new killer doesn't kill him?
Life of an agent.
Yeah, well, I'm no longer an agent, apparently.
Sorry. Look, I can't get you the bureau dossier on the torturer now, as you can imagine. But we can find out some public information. And I have something else you need to see.
Okay. Well, it's too dangerous for me to come to the bureau. Can you meet me at the city library?
You know there's been a fire there. The whole thing's shut down for repairs.
Exactly. There's damage, but there's gotta be a terminal or two still working. And no one will know. Can you meet me there in 15 minutes?
I'll be there.
That means the cops.
You need to get the hell out of there.
Get down! the hell was that?
Thomas, I'm at the library. Where are you?
Rosa, be quiet.
Hey, Smithy! Johnson, wait up!
Rosa, are you still there?
Very few people can tell me to shut up and get away with it.
Sorry, I'll be there in a couple minutes.
Hurry, I have a feeling I'm not alone here.
Thank you.